University of Mexico. By the Tipsy Tuna, powered by L&R Liquors, as well as Pelican. For the start of the professional international boxing. We have one boxer ready at the way at the ring as we await the other. In beautiful Plasencia from Veracruz, Mexico, weighing in at 110 pounds with a record of one loss and one draw, Sebastian El Buitre El Buitre is representing the Fabrica de Campanas from Soledad Doblado, Veracruz, Mexico. And representing Belize, ladies and gentlemen, in the flyweight division. From San Ignacio, weighing in at 110 pounds, representing the Lion's Den Gym with 13-0 in his amateur record, and on his professional card, 2 wins, no losses. Ladies and gentlemen, he's none other than Carlos Sims. gentlemen, as we prepare for four rounds of professional boxing, it's gonna be 3-minute rounds. Please remember. Don't forget to remember that it's gonna be three-minute rounds. It's based on a 10-point system sanctioned by the WBC from Mexico. The man in the middle for the match, Rafael Arroyo. The judges are Nathaniel Paon, Oscar Rodriguez, and Henry Usher. The cut man, Dr. Pedro Chu. This is the first professional fight of the match in the flyweight division. And that's the end of the first round. And stepping into the ring once again, the lovely Jolie Pollard. Jolie Pollard, She is the founder of her own hair product line called Ikuma. Ladies and gentlemen, Ikuma is a seaweed made product right here on the peninsula. And if you want to know what Ikuma can do, just check out the flare in Jolie's hair. Here we have round number two. Sebastian Benitez is Coach Miguel Rancherito Fernandez from Veracruz, Mexico. It's his first time in Belize for boxing. They've been training for about 2 months for this fight, and they're here for the win and also to win the hearts of the Belizean people. He wants to work with the Belize Boxing Association, and they're looking towards a bright future. And here we are getting ready for round number three.
Hit the jump one. Yes, hit the jump. Hit the jump. Hit the jump.
Yeah.
boy. Get the drop. Yeah.
Back onto the stage in her high heels, the Belizean beauty, Andrea Berry. The coach for Belize's Carlos Silvero is Coach Martinez, Asad Marquardt of the Lions Den in Cayo. He also trains the Mechanical Silvero Acosta Smith, just a couple of the names. And he sees Belizean boxing progressing. And we have naturally talented individuals here, but we haven't created a system that can foster their development.
Oh!
Representing Belize, Carlos and Mexico, Sebastian El Mitre Benitez. As we wait for the score from the judges, are you not entertained? Right here from the Tipsy Tuna. Remember to keep your ticket stubs close as we have another raffle coming up for you after this match. That raffle is gonna be for a one night stay at Miramar right here on the peninsula of Placentia, as well as another raffle after that for two bottles of Ikuma hair product by Jolie Pollard. So this is a little time for you to visit the bar, get something to drink, quench your thirst. Gentlemen, this first raffle Miramar. Jolie Pollard is gonna pick for us. It's another premium ticket. And the number, ladies and gentlemen, 1, 4, 2, 142 is the winning number. Do we have a winner? Anybody with a premium ticket, 1, 4, 2. We have a winner. Hold on. Bring it up. That's a general ticket. All right. We have 4 guys for the push-up competition. The push-up competition is for $100. Five guys confirmed for the boxing. For the push-ups, do we have any more? Would you like to donate anymore? We're accepting donations right here on the side with the judges. Anybody else? push-up competition is none other than Nick Collin. And we have a female going up as well. $140. $140, ladies and gentlemen. Do we have any donations on this side? Do we have any donations to the push-up competition? Would you like to donate $5, $10? $10, we've got another $10 donation. We're at $150, ladies and gentlemen. Anything else? Anything else? Donations, got it? What? Americano. More donations right here. Dr. Pedro, please come. We have our tabulator for the push-up competition is none other than Dr. Pedro Chu, all the way from Independence. All right. Do we have anyone else wanting to contest inside the ring? Anybody else? All right. Ladies and gentlemen, please take a look at Nick Pollard. Nick is going to be the judge of the push-up competition. Nick, would you like to give them an explanation of what you want right here?
I'm just saying that we don't want to push-up. So you're going to go straight now. Make sure your chest is almost.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to need your cooperation for this. So when you see the guys starting to strut their stuff on this, showing off their muscles, we need you guys to count with us. They're not going together. Well, one by one, we could be here all night. All right, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number one, Jonah. Contestant number two, Phil. Contestant number three, Adam. Contestant number four, Leon Garcia. Contestant number five, Elon Galang Razorblade Cuevas. Contestant number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is none other than Placentia's very own Evolution Gym, El Gallo. Contestant number 7 is gonna be Erwin. And contestant number 8, ladies and gentlemen, our only female for the push-up competition. All right, ladies and gentlemen, two at a time. We're gonna do two at a time. Take out your cell phones. You can go live. We have Jonah and Phil. Are you gonna do it on your knees? That's a female push-up. I'm just saying. Are you guys ready? We're gonna count them down. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. I'm confused. We gotta start again. I'm confused. So they're not going together at the same time? My bad. Hate the player, not the game. Alright. Alright, hold on. Since they already did some, we're gonna let them rest a little bit and put them back for last. Can we get our next two contestants? Adam and Leo. Alright, I was confused a little bit. We have your name, sir? Mr. Price is gonna count for Leon, and Nick is gonna count for Adam. Let's keep them a countdown, ladies and gentlemen. 1, 2, 3.
Push-ups.
I will be doing the real push-up.
The real push-up. that you gotta be in an erect position. You can't have your bumper up in the air. You've got to level off your bumper. Lira's still coming. Lira, at the moment, Lira is like Daddy Yankee style. Shaky, 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 shaky. But she's getting him done.
Competition.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, Razorblade would like to give you a demonstration real quick before we leave the stage. He is challenging the winner. Razorblade is challenging the winner. Can you do this? Here he comes again, ladies and gentlemen. He's on his big thumbs. Holy guacamole. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. 10 push-ups on his big thumb. You already got your money, you don't have to go. Unless you wanted to go for double or nothing, but we don't have that cash. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this next match. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, your next match coming up is a lightweight match. Another international fight. Remember, it's going to be 4 rounds, 3 minute rounds. Are the boxers ready? Coach, are the boxers ready? Alright, ladies and gentlemen, representing the Kilkat Gym from Petén, Guatemala. He's 25 years old, weighing in at 135 pounds. His professional record boasts a 3-win, 0-loss. His name is Joel El Cobra Milton. Stepping up to the ring is Joel, if it's in Spanish, we gotta say it like that, Joel Milton. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, Joel Milton! Milton says this is not his first time in Belize, as he has fought twice before here and won both. However, it is his first time in Placencia. He's been training over 2 months for this match. And he's here to give it all he's got, and hopefully come away with the win. And Joel Milton is going up against the man from the Polysmart Gym in Belize City. He's 18 years old at 135 pounds. His amateur record boasts 5 wins, 0 loss. And his professional record, 1 win with 0 loss. Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you Amir King Mir Ruba! Amir has a lot of family here down in the south. The Bardales family, the Rodon family, the Muschamp family. And they're all here tonight in support of King Mir. In the silver trunks with the black strap and red gloves is Joel Cobra Milton, and in the red trunks with the white strap and the white gloves, Amir Rudon.
Yeah.
Remember this match is an international four-round match, 3 minutes around, and it is sanctioned by the WBC of Mexico. It's based on a 10-point score sheet. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for some boxing? Yeah! It's his second professional fight, and he's looking to bring the win for Believe! Here's the second round.
Yeah!
That's the end of the second round, ladies and gentlemen. Stepping up into the ring is gonna be... Once again... The Ikoma Lady, Jolie Puller. Here's the start of round number three. That's the end of round number three, and back into the ring, Bridget Kramer. Bridget would like you all to remember to support her Co-Placencia. Co-Placencia is a GoPro and an accessory rental right here on the peninsula of Placencia. Co-Placencia, venture, explore, record. With one more round of professional boxing left in this. Can Amir bring home the W4 Belize? Yeah. 3 minutes. got some boxing left. Gentlemen, after four rounds of boxing, we have the decision. Ladies and gentlemen, by unanimous decision, Amir! Undisputed champion, King Miruna! Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with your champion, Amir King Miruna. Amir, an excellent fight here in the mic. I'm just kidding you. At the Tipsy Tuna, you have a lot of fans here. Amir, first of all, the whole of Belize is behind you. I heard a lot of comments about Sarah Stone and all that. But how you feel you performed tonight? I know you've been training for a while. Let's hear from you. What's your next move from here?
I'll just continue to grow and continue to become smarter and stronger as a fighter. And one day,
hopefully, I'll become a champion. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, Amir Miruna! Remember, we have a couple more raffles coming up, ladies and gentlemen. We're gonna have an intermission, but coming up next is gonna be your main event. Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to take a picture with your winner, Amir Miruna, he's right by the ring. I know a lot of his family and friends are here supporting him all around, from all around the country. Between Mecánico Esquivel and René Campana de León. Resort.
I love the vibe of the Belizeans to bring. The excellent crowd at the Gypsy Tuna right now. I never expect this. I'll be honest with you. We had a little couple of rains over the past couple of days, and when you have rains like that, you know, a lot of Belizeans, they kind of like stay at their house. You know, but excellent crowd here tonight. Cyril from the Tipsy Tuna, and the people loving the vibe, and they're all behind the Belizean boxers to the next match. Man, I love the sport. I love how it goes so far. I've been a boxing fan. Me and my grandpa watch boxing almost every Saturday night when I was growing up. You know, and to have him here sideline watching this, getting excited every time a big blow come, you know, a good feeling. Yeah, good feeling.
Respect.
Thanks, man.
Yes, man.
Resort is conveniently located just a couple miles off the coast of Tangriga. If you don't want a raffle, we can also sell this one to the highest bidder. The lady who's making all of this possible here at the Tipsy Tuna. Our very own cheer lady right here from Plasencia, Miss Ilsa. I know your hands are full, Ilsa, but can you please come pick this ticket for us? The winning ticket. A premium ticket, ladies and gentlemen. Take out your ticket stubs. A premium ticket, number 114. 114. What? Come on. You got it? Bring it. Bring it. Bring it. All right, we have a winner for the Coco Plum Island Resort. One night stay for two. Max, hi. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner is Maxi Dax. Fox says he's gonna take the highest bidder if you would like his ticket. He's starting at 10,000. I'm sorry, it's for a one night stay, not a one night stand. A couple of you are hearing that, I just gotta make myself clear. Can we get one more lucky lady to pick? As we have another raffle just donated by the chair lady of Placentia for $100 for Lobster Fest. We're gonna ask someone else who is making everything possible here tonight, one of the biggest boxing fans, Mr. Antonio Zabane. He's a former boxer, a former trainer. Tony Zab. The winning ticket is another premium, number 60. 60, number 60. That is the preacher. I'd like to have a little interview with a lovely lady. Her name is none other than Miss Shamila, the sweet, the beautiful, the lovely, the fantastic, the supercalifragilisticexpialidocious parish to the Tipsy Tuna a lot tonight. You're here for a different something. It's for boxing live at the Tipsy Tuna. Are you enjoying it here tonight, Miss Parrish?
One.
Can you make that sound any more seductive? Stop, stop, stop. I've had enough. A quick check on the boxes, ladies and gentlemen, and we're gonna be back right now for the start of the main event. Thank you. tonight. Can we please get the boxers at ringside? Ladies and gentlemen, gentlemen, once again we're coming to you live from the Tipsy Tuna. The main event is another professional bout. This one's gonna be 8 rounds of boxing, 8 3-minute rounds, and it's a featherweight bout. From Guatemala City, swag your music volume. All the way from Guatemala City, boasting a 74 win and 2 loss in his amateur record, and a 1 win and 1 draw in his professional record. And representing Belize, ladies and gentlemen, from San Ignacio Cayo, from the Lion's Den Gym, he boasts a 13-win-3-loss professional record at 28 years of age, 126 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, Eduardo! Ladies and gentlemen, before the start of this match, swag your music. Maybe I'm foolish, maybe I'm blind. To see through this, see what's behind. Ladies and gentlemen, we're asking if you can all stand on your feet, and we're going to have a 10 count for one of boxing's biggest fans who passed away this morning. His name is Mr. Carl Pickwood, and we're going to have a 10 count now. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for some boxing? Ladies and gentlemen, in the black trunks, white strap, and white gloves, Rene Campana de Leon. And in the red trunks, silver gloves, and white waist strap, Mecánico Esquivel!
chanting. La mano de adelante. Vamos. Más velocidad en contraataque. Abajo también. A izquierda abajo. Seguí trabajando la mano adelante, prepara la derecha. Este se la han cruzado, la derecha. Esa es. No dejes que tire primero, vamos. ¡Yes! ¡Otra vez! ¡Seguí igual! ¡Seguí con la mano adelante!
Stepping into the ring, the lovely Sarah. Here we have Sarah strutting her stuff in her high waist, Abercrombie jeans. Her top is from Forever 21. Give it up for the lovely Sarah. Here we have the start of round number two. Remember, it's 8 3-minute rounds.
Con la mano adelante. Seguí con la mano adelante. Esa es, seguí empezando, no dejes que le empiece. Llévate esa izquierda, la tire lenta. Thank you. las piernas ahí, no dejes que te peguen la esquina. Encontrá esa izquierda o llévatela. Prepara la derecha.
Where's the end of round number two? Stepping up to the ring in her silver spike heels. She's the owner of the Dealer Boutique right here in Plasencia. The lovely Andrea Berry. Here we are now at the start of round number three. That's the end of round number three. And stepping up into the ring once again is Miss Kramer. In the meantime and in between time, we must give a shout out to our sponsors one again. L&R Liquors, Belly Kid, Island Breeze in Dangriga, Coco Plum Island Resort, Altitude Fitness, Tony's Superstore, Miramar, Sea Spray Hotel, M&M Hardware, Sourcing Unlimited, Atlantic Bank, Blue Corner Promotions, Top Value Supermarket, and Smart, bringing people together. Gentlemen, all the way from the UK, the lovely Miss Sophie. Here we have Sophie strutting her stuff on stage. Sophie is one of the original classics in her Reeboks. Start of the front row.
Thank you.
And there we have the end of round number four. And welcome the lovely Laura. Laura strutting around in the Air Force One. And this is going into round six. There it And here we have with us, ladies and gentlemen, one of the amateur fighters, Derek Villanueva, to give you a couple words.
Thanks for the opportunity of saying a couple words. For you guys who don't know me, I am Derek Villanueva. My roots are from Placencia, as you know the last name Villanueva. I just want to bring up my sponsor, who's sponsoring me, which is Gaylor, known as Tropicana, right? You can link their Facebook page. You can also do online shopping with them, and they will ship to you. Thank you guys for your support here tonight.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, Derek Villanueva. Start of round six. That's the end of round number six. Stepping up, once again, Jesse Lopez. Jesse Lopez in a black one piece from Fashion Nova. And a cover-up, a white cover-up see-through. But the see-through is cover-up.
Hey, Peter.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, round number 7. That's the end of round number 7. Ladies and gentlemen, back on stage, Sarah Ali! Ladies and gentlemen, remember after the fight is over, if you'd like to take pictures with any of the boxers or the lovely ring ladies, they're going to be right here. And you can take pictures with them on stage, stage side, whatever your little heart desires. Can we have a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for the two boxers? This is the final round. Campana Mecánico.
Watch your fear.
From the judges, we'd like to thank you all in advance for coming up to the Tipsy Tuna. Do remember, the party continues over at the Tipsy Tuna tonight. The coach, we had a couple of words last night with the coach from Guatemala. His name is Coach Hector Arriola. He says he's been working with René Campana de León for over a year, and he has other boxers as well, but de León is far his best. He knows Mexico is strong, but he is comfortable that de León will win. It's his first time in Belize, but feel that Belize can open doors in the boxing world. He feels comfortable being here, and the people treat him really nice, and he's grateful for that. He wants the best man to win tonight, and he believes there's a possibility for Belizean boxers to go to Guatemala to train as well as compete. There's an upcoming tournament on the 6th of July, and all Belizean boxers are welcome. The man in the middle for the match, Mr. Arriola. Remember, this match was sanctioned by the WBC from Mexico. Coach Hector and Coach Martinez. Just a little bit more time as we await the final decision from the tabulator. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the time has come for us to find out the winner of the main event. Ladies and gentlemen, we have both boxers in the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, the time has come. The winner of your main event is none other than Eduardo Mecánico Esquivel! Here is your winner, ladies and gentlemen, Eduardo Esquivel! Campana. Let's talk to the champion first, Eduardo Mecánico Esquivel. With that English, right? That's why on the flyer it says third time's a charm. You came into the match with a strategy tonight. How do you feel you executed that strategy? All right, Campana. Mi español es muy mal, no te preocupes. Pero, ¿cómo te sientes después del partido?
You win, Pita.
Belize in America.
America is Belize.
We call for the war.
Campana saying that he is the winner of the fight here, ladies and gentlemen.
But
give us a few words.